A very good morning to all of you. So today we will discuss morphology, life cycle, pathogenicity and lab diagnosis of Anthamoeba histolytica. So Anthamoeba histolytica is an intestinal parasite, so which is responsible for causing diarrhea. In today's lecture we will discuss about its morphology, mode of transmission, life cycle, clinical feature and pathology, its prevention and control, and lab diagnosis. So this slide shows the geographical distribution of Anthamoeba histolytica. So Anthamoeba histolytica, it has a cosmopolitan distribution. That means it is found everywhere. It is mainly present in tropic and subtropic regions. So the chances of infections are more if adequate personal hygiene is not maintained. If proper disposal of fecal matter is not done, it can lead to the environmental pollution. And thirdly, if the water supply is not properly maintained, so that can lead to the mixing of sewage water. So now we will discuss the habitat of Anthamoeba histolytica. So trophozoites, they are mainly found in large intestine, liver abscesses and other interintestinal organs. Whereas cysts, they are mainly found in stool of chronic patients and the carriers. So now we will discuss morphology of Anthamoeba histolytica. So in morphology, so Anthamoeba histolytica, it exists in three phases. First one is trophozoid, and second one is pre-cystic stage, and third one is cystic stage. So first we will discuss trophozoid stage. It is growing and feeding stage of parasite. The size of parasite is vary from 12 micrometer to 35 micrometer. The shape of parasite is in elongated form when actively motile, and rounded form when at rest. So in this picture you can clearly see the shape of trophozoid. So it is in elongated form. So next is motility. So it perform active and progressive motility, and the motility is in one directional. So you can say it's a directional motility, which is done with the help of pseudopodia. So pseudopodia, as I told you earlier, that they are the false feet. So the cytoplasm of the trophozoid is well differentiated into ectoplasm and endoplasm. So the nucleus of trophozoid is single, so it is not clearly visible, but when it is stained with the iodine, so then you can see it clearly. In pre-cystic stage, so the parasite, it becomes round, or you can say it is slightly ovoid in shape. The size of pre-cystic stage vary from 10 micrometer to 20 micrometer. The pseudopodia, it is in blunt form, and the large nuclear structure is present in the center. The third stage is cyst. The size of cyst, it varies from 12 micrometer to 15 micrometer. So the shape of cyst is spherical. So you can see the shape of cyst. So 1 to 4 nucleus are present. So here you can see 4 nucleus. Nuclear membrane is thin. So this is nucleus. So you can see this membrane is thin and regular. So with the compact central karyosome. So in the center you can see the karyosome. So which is in compact form. So when the cyst is stained, so you can see the cytoplasm, it appears yellowish gray and granular in nature. The stored food in cyst is sausage shaped chromatidial bars with blunt ends. So this is the stored food material. So in immature cyst, glycogen mass with 1 or 2 nuclei is present. So this slide shows the mode of transmission. So the infective stage of the Anthamoeba histolytica is tetranucleate mature cyst. Men acquire this infection mainly with the ingestion of foods or drinks which are contaminated with the infecting cyst, or if the hands of the persons, they are contaminated. The life cycle of Entamoeba histolytica starts with ingestion of mature cyst. So when someone consume contaminated food or water, so these cysts enter into the stomach through oral route. So then it ultimately reaches to the small intestine. So in small intestine, excystation of mature cyst it occurs. So this leads to the formation of trophozoite. So when these trophozoites they are released, they are multinucleated. So with maturations, they are converted into mononucleated trophozoites. So these mononucleated trophozoites, they are present in large intestine. So in the large intestines, so they invade the intestine. So it leads to ulcerations. So the ulcers are large and they are flask shaped. So these trophozoites, they can even move towards other organs. During this infection, bloody mucus containing diarrhea, it occurs with the lower abdominal discomfort. During this time, some of the trophozoites, they undergo encystations. So ultimately, they are converted into a mature cyst. So ultimately, they become mature cyst. So these mature cysts, they are secreted with the stool. The mature cyst in the stool, they can further act as a source of infection.